the time, we were coming up with hundreds and thousands of dollars. If you get into a location, there'd be a closet filled with money. The federal government started seizing the money. Then the way they worked it out, that money was given back to the agency that seized it. Then that agency would use the money to fight the battle on drugs, supposedly. Captain had a meeting with us and he said, you know, if you want to keep your job, you keep taking that money because the sheriff's department needs it. The focus left, get the dope off the street to get as much money as you can and bring it in. The guy said, you know what? We got $500,000 here we're going to turn into evidence. What's going to happen to it? The first time I was given money, I'm in a parking lot, guy walks up to me, one of my partners, and he says, here, this is your share. I look in the paper bag and there's some money. And that's when I'm thinking, okay, what the hell do I do? Do I take it and stay part of the crew? Do I say, no, I don't want this, and then I get labeled a snitch? Took the bag, stuck it under the seat. Now, once you've done that, you're dirty. There's no going back. And then pretty soon everybody's coming up with a brand new car. I'm buying a vacation home. I'm going to Hawaii. The greed came in. We had gone from being cops to crooks, and we were living like that.